read you a book, Goldilocks and the Three Bears. For Betty, Sally, and Joe, and for Miramam. Once upon a time, there were three bears who lived together in a house of their own in a wood. One of them was a little small wee bear, and one was a middle-sized bear, and the other was a great huge bear. They each had a bowl of their porridge, a little bowl for the little small wee bear, a middle-sized bowl for the middle-sized bear, a great huge bowl for the great huge bear. And they each had a chair to sit in, a little chair for the little small wee bear, middle-sized bear for the middle-sized bear, and a great huge chair for the great huge bear, and they each had a bed to sleep in, a little bed for the little small wee bear, a middle-sized bed for the middle-sized bear, and a great huge bed for the great huge bear. One day after they had made their porridge for breakfast, the porridge poured it into the porridge bowls. They walked out into the woods while the porridge was cooling. And while they were walking, a little girl named Goldilocks came to their house. First she looked in the window, then she peeked in the keyhole, and seeing no one was at home, she lifted the latch. The door opened before her, and she went. How pleased Goldilocks when she saw the steaming porridge on the table, the sweet smell of the porridge with roasted nuts, honey, and berries filled the room. It was so tempting that Goldilocks set about helping herself. First, she tasted the porridge of the great huge bear, but it was too hot. Then she tasted the porridge of the middle-sized bear, but that was too cold. And then she tried the porridge of the little small wee bear, and it was neither too hot nor too cold. It was just right. She liked it so much that she ate it all up. Then Goldilocks sat down in the chair of the great huge bear, but it was too hard for her. Then she sat down in the chair of the middle-sized bear, but it was too soft for her. And then she sat down in the chair of the little small wee bear, and the chair was neither too hard nor too soft, but just right. So Goldilocks seated herself in it, and there she sat until the bottom of the chair gave way, and down she came plump upon the floor. Then Goldilocks went upstairs to the bedroom in which the three bears slept. First, she lay down upon the bed of the great huge bear, but that was too high and at the head for her. Then she lay down upon the bed of this middle-sized bear, but that was too high at the foot for her. Then she lay down upon the bed of the little small wee bear, and that was neither too high at the head or nor foot, but just right. So she covered herself up comfortably and fell fast asleep. By this time, the three bears thought their porridge would be cool enough to eat. So they turned home for breakfast. Now Goldilocks had left the spoon of the great huge bear standing up in the porridge. "Somebody has been at my porridge," said the great huge bear in the great, great rough, gruff voice. And when the middle-sized bear looked in hers, she saw the spoon was standing in it too. "Somebody has been at my porridge," said the middle bear in her middle voice. Then the little wee bear looked at his bowl, and the spoon was in the porridge bowl, but the porridge was all gone. "Somebody has been at the ate my porridge and has eaten it all up," said the little small wee bear in his little small wee voice. Upon this, the three bears, seeing that somebody had entered their house and eaten up little small wee bear's breakfast, began to look about them. Now Goldilocks had not put the hard cushion straight when she rose from the chair of the great huge bear. "Somebody has been sitting in my chair," said the great huge bear in his great rough, gruff voice. And Goldilocks had crumbled the soft cushion of the middle-sized bear. "Somebody has been sitting in my chair," said the middle-sized bear in her middle voice. And you know that Goldilocks had done to the third chair. "Somebody has been sitting in my chair and has sat the bottom right off it," said the little small wee bear in his little small wee voice. Then the bear thought it necessary that they should make a further search, so they went upstairs to their bedroom. Now Goldilocks had pulled the pillow of the great huge bear out of place. Its place. "Somebody has been laying in my bed," said the great huge bear in his great rough, gruff voice. And Goldilocks had pulled the cover of the middle-sized bear out of its place. "Somebody has been laying in my bed," said the middle-sized bear in little voice. And then the little small wee bear came to look at his bed. There was Goldilocks sleeping peacefully, her long shiny braids spread across his pillow. Little small wee bear just stared at her for a moment and didn't say anything. But then he cried, "Somebody has been laying in my bed," and here she is. Goldilocks had heard in her sleep a great rough, gruff voice of the great huge bear and a middle voice of the middle-sized bear, but the only was if had heard someone speaking in a dream. But when she heard the little small wee bear,
I'm gonna read it right.
The small wee voice of the little small wee bear, it was so sharp and shrill And so, like, her own that it awakened her at once. Up she started, and when she saw the three bears on one side of the bed, she tumbled herself off the other and ran to the window. Out Goldilocks jumped and ran away as fast as she could run, not looking behind until she was very far away. And what happened to Goldilocks afterwards, no one can tell, but the three bears never saw anything more of her.